a remarkable story, incredible. And the book is great. It's The Girl Who Climbed Everest, because you're only a kid.
Well, what, 22?
22 yeah. years old. So what on earth? I know everybody asks you this. I know they do. Why?
Oh, God.
Not just because it's there, but why? Why did you
have to read the book? I fell in love with the idea that you could stand on the summit of Everest and you could look down and you could see the curvature of the earth beneath
wow.
you. Everest was the start and... yeah, still climbing today.
You're still doing it? You're
yes,
still
haven't yeah, I love it.
Put off at all. Now, you did have bulimia for a while.
I did.
Did this help you with that?
When I started writing the book, I wondered whether I should mention it because it's obviously, those things are quite private.
Of
but
course
I
they
thought,
are, yeah.
I've got to talk about it because if one young girl reads this book and speaks out about it or something, then it's worth it. So, yeah, and I feel like it was quite a brave thing to do, but I'm proud I did it, and I think we should talk more.
So do I, so do yeah. I. And when somebody may be sitting at home watching this who's going through that, because it's a horrible, horrible illness.
Yeah.
It's really awful, and as you said, very secretive and all of that. And we should talk about it, but they're looking at you now, looking so healthy, able to climb Everest.
Exactly.
You know, that elite band of people who've been able to do that. When you get to the stage where they talk about the death zone, the last bit.
Yes.
What is that actually like?
So the death zone is above 8,000 metres.
Right.
And there are only 14 mountains in the world that go above 8,000 metres. And Everest is much higher than that.
Sure.
So we have to climb using bottled oxygen. Your body is shutting down. Every hour you spend in there, you're slowly dying. So every hour you're in a race against time.
Wow.
So we don't sleep up there, really. We climb through the night so we can get to the summit and get down as fast as we can.
Your mum and dad got a call saying that you'd perished. They got a call saying that you were, first of all, in danger.
Yeah.
I mean, that's terrible.
My poor parents, I've put them through so much. So I was on the mountain. I had no idea that anyone knew that I'd had a fall apart from my team, and it was just one of those things, and we were okay. But word had spread down the mountain back home, and I think my parents got a very awful phone call in the middle of the night from a journalist saying,
ooh.
I think something, you know, your daughter might be dead. What do you have to say about that? And my poor stepdad didn't say anything to my mum. He
right.
held that in the whole night thinking, I can't tell her until we've got more news. So they went through so much, poor parents with daughter as risk-taking as me.
But they must be very proud of you as well. I mean, obviously, they're going to worry. I mean, we all worry as parents anyway when our kids are crossing the street, never mind climbing
yeah.
the highest mountain in the world.
My poor mum, she just wants me to have a kid. She just wants me to have a baby. And
That won't stop
yeah.
you, though. That won't stop you. You'll still do it. You'll still do it. What's the next? Because I know I shouldn't say that to you because you've done this already, but have you got another expedition, another something else planned?
So the mountains will always be there, and I have to weigh up whether I want to go and do another big expedition or whether I do want to move on and have family, because I'm finding it very difficult to weigh up how you can have both.
Sure.
So we'll see. I'm just enjoying climbing, and now the book is done, I feel like that was a mountain in itself.
Yes.
And we're just going to go back and enjoy climbing for climbing's sake.
It's if you're interested at all in Everest, it's a cracking story, but actually it's a brilliant story on its own.
Yeah.
You know, you don't need to be interested in climbing or anything like that. It's just a really good story. Of your life. Bonita, it's out now, isn't it? Bonita Norris, The Girl Who Climbed Everest. Wow.
Thank you.
Nobody can ever take that away from you. That
Thank you, Lorraine.